May 17th, the Till Center, Long Island Real Estate Revolution. The way Salsa changed my life, we're gonna change your life by telling you how we do this. Value-add real estate investing, apartment buildings, fix and flips, tax liens, tax deeds. But the thing that will explode your wealth more than anything in this world is value-add rental properties. This is a 5-unit across the street. I'm gonna show you how I took this from buying it for $512,000 and turning it into something that's gonna be worth $1.2 million. You know how I did that? With none of my own money. Take a look. Like I said, the way real estate investors become very, very wealthy is by creating value in a value-add type of scenario. What does that mean? It means they buy something for X, usually with other people's money. They renovate it, bump rents, etc. Increase the value to Y, refinance it, give the investors all their money back. They increase their net worth by the arbitrage between what the mortgage is and what the value of the property is. And then they have cash flow that pays everything down every month and gives them leftover money that goes directly into their pocket. In order to do that, you have to get very creative, especially in a market like this. And that's exactly what we're gonna show you how to do on May 17th at the Till Center. So right now we're standing inside a 5-unit apartment building that I purchased a number of months ago, right? Got an excellent price, $512,000. When we're done with this, it's gonna be worth $1.2 million. How do we do that? We see what we have as a blank canvas, and then we know we have to create something that will generate a great living environment for somebody that generates maximum return. How do we do that? We have this box. How many bedrooms can we fit it? How many bathrooms can we fit it? We go and we look at the CDC and the Section 8 websites and we see, okay, listen, what's the minimum bedroom size? What's the minimum common area size? What's the minimum bathroom size? What's the maximum? What are the parking requirements? And say, okay, based on what the zoning and rules are in this particular township, in this area, how do we maximize our unit count to generate as much revenue as possible to boost the value on this so we can get in for as little as possible, refinance out as much as possible, pay our investors back with their interest so they're happy and they move on to the next deal, and we increase our net worth and have something that we can give to our children and something that can take care of us in our old age and in our retirement. So let's take a look through. This is a 3 2-bedrooms, 2 1-bedrooms. I'm gonna take you through the design and exactly how we did this to lay it out for maximum return. First thing I want to reinforce with rentals is always this. Design and build your rentals to be the same as if you wanted to live in them. You treat your tenants like gold, they will treat you like gold, pay the rent, increase the value of your property, and allow you to pass something on to generations to come. So every rental we do looks exactly like this. We gut renovate everything. New electric, new plumbing, new sheetrock, new insulation, new. It also boosts the value of what it's worth after. You get out of it what you put into it all the time. So what I want people to do is, when you look at these rentals, and we have a video on this with single family, you look at the floor plate and you say, what can I fit into it? It's not what it is now, it's what it can be turned into. And draw it out, doodle, work on it with your architect, Captain Permit. Call them up and say, I have this space. How many bedrooms can I fit into it legally? How many bathrooms? How do I maximize my rent roll? That's what you do in order to create value, and that's exactly what we did here. When you buy a rental property, you have to understand the market. Whether you're gonna be working with a program tenant, or you're gonna be working with regular cash, private pay people, you have to understand. If you're gonna be working with, let's say, cash market rate tenants, you have to have a great rental agent, you have to have access to the MLS, you have to see exactly what the market demands or commands for studios, 1-bedroom, 2-bedroom, whatever it is that you're designing. And make sure that you tour these properties to make sure that your amenities and square footage align so that you're getting the rents that you need. If you're working with a program like a CDC or a Section 8 or a DSS or a VA or a HUDVASH or anything like that, these guys have landlord forms. Once a month, you can go in and you can sit with them and they'll tell you what they consider fair market rent. What are the different utility allowances? What do they subtract for electric heat, oil heat, gas heat? And then you could design your units to fit their criteria for maximum return. If you're gonna do anything, you don't wanna just buy something and try to renovate it and rent it. You wanna know what you're doing, go in educated, buy it, design it, and have the end game in place already, and that's what we do every time. There are thousands of deals just like this all over Long Island. Deals where you can buy with none of your own money, renovate, build value, refinance out, give your investors back their money, own a property with zero or a little bit of money out of your own pocket, generate massive returns, and change your life. Thank you, Raider, for watching. My name is Charles Weinroff, AKA The Handsome Home Buyer, AKA Captain Permit, AKA El Judio Maravilloso, AKA the soon-to-be 2020 LLS Man of the Year. If you like what you see, click the subscribe button. If you want to learn exactly what I do and the other top investors do day in and day out to generate long-term generational wealth, go to LI Real Estate Revolution, buy a ticket, give to a great cause, help cure cancer. See you there on the 17th.